When it comes to desktop processors, Intel takes the lion's share of the market with 5 processor families covering the low, mid, and high-end segments. Ranging from the budget offers to the most expensive, they are Celeron, Pentium, Core i3, Core i5, Core i7 and Core i9. In this video, let's dig deeper into this Intel processors and help decide which processors are made for what audiences. What is Celeron processors? The lowest cost budget lineup from Intel. Celeron processors primarily compete against AMD's AM1 accelerated processing unit offerings. In fact, this may be the one market where Intel is the underdog, playing second fiddle to AMD. Compared to other Intel lines, the Celeron family is comprised almost entirely of dual-core processors with less cache memory and slower clock speeds. But they are viable options for embedded PCs that will mostly see basic usage. Ideal usage of Celeron processor is for automation PCs, custom NAS systems, and digital signage. What is Pentium processors? Not too long ago, Pentium processors used to be Intel's flagship line. But now, they are the little brother to Intel's Core series of CPUs. The Pentium family is comprised of mostly dual-core processors positioned above the Celerons and designed for buyers prioritizing cost and value over performance. In terms of performance, they have slightly higher performance specifications than Celeron processors. Ideal usage of Pentium processors are basic day-to-day office usage, such as word processing or composing emails, and digital signage. What is Core i3? Core i3 is your most basic option. These are generally targeted at people who don't do a lot of multitasking and gaming. As a result, they cost very little. If you want to browse the internet or use Microsoft Office effortlessly, the latest Core i3 processor should be enough. Ideal usage of Core i3 processors are moderate duty office usage, such as editing spreadsheets, word processing, and photo editing. WePro technology enables remote management. What is Core i5? Core i5 is a great option for multitasking and a moderate amount of gaming. Core i5 stock keeping units are a tad bit expensive than Core i3s. But, you do end up getting a lot of extra horsepower for that extra amount. Ideal usage of Core i5 processors are moderate to heavy office usage requiring a lot of multitasking, such as keeping an email program while browsing the internet or working with large database files. Also a prime choice for graphic designers primarily using image editing programs such as Photoshop. What is Core i7? Core i7 processors are mainly targeted towards gaming enthusiasts and content creators. When paired with the right GPUs, Core i7 should be able to handle anything you throw at it. This includes AAA gaming titles, heavy video editing, and 3D object rendering. Ideal usage of Core i7 processors are processor-intensive tasks such as editing, encoding, gaming, and animating videos. What is Core i9? Core i9 processors are a tad bit faster than Core i7s. One of the significant differentiating factors between them is better hyperthreading, which enhances parallel computing. Things like higher core count, more cache, and higher core clock speed make Core i9 better than Core i7 processors. So which Intel processor do you need? To recap, Celerons and Pentiums for embedded systems and basic usage. i3s and i5s for most mainstream office tasks. And i7s and i9s only for power users. In the comments below, let us know which Intel processor you use in your everyday workstation. Thanks for watching this video. View video description for more details. Subscribe to our YouTube channel for more interesting videos.